You won't be holding no damn shooting match on it.
This sure is your lucky day, Mrs. Wilson, because we're also going to be looking for 10 of your best rooms.
Are you out of your head? I just had Pony Bill and his Far East show staying here, and all they did was chase women up and down my front stairs. And on horseback.
Our folks would never dream of doing that, Mrs. Wilson. They're too refined. They'd do it on your back stairs. Come on, Mrs. Wilson, what do you got to lose?
Soap, spoons, towels, bath mats, salt shakers, whatever's not nailed down. It's the last time, mister. Get off of my lawn!
Mrs. Wilson! Mrs. Wilson!
With all the deluxe hotels in Cincinnati, who would have thought we'd end up in a place like this?
Cannot sit down these bags.
Oh, put them over there, Tommy. Be careful not to drop them. I got all my beauty aids there.
No wonder they're so heavy.
Why do you always have to treat Tommy like a bellboy? He's a very important part of the show, and I happen to be his assistant, same as you and Frank Butler.
It's fine, Winnie.
See? Even an Indian has more sense than you.
He's half Indian, sis.
And that's the half I was talking to. But you always talk to him like some kind of uncivilized heathen.
I do not.
Tommy, let's put those bags back down over there. You can go around back and set up your teeping.
Please stop, sis.
It's fine, Winnie. Honest, I have things I have to do anyways.
Really, sis?
Winnie! Mama was lying on her deathbed. She made me promise I'd protect you, my baby sister, and keep you from harm. And that's what I'm gonna do, even if it kills you.
I don't need protecting anymore. I'm not a child. Tommy, wait!
Winnie Tate, you get back here. Hello, Frank. Well, Frank, I guess you haven't noticed where we are.
And where's that, Dolly?
Cincinnati, Frank. Remember? 5 years ago, when we went walking along the shore?
There's no shore in Cincinnati, Dolly. You must be thinking of Cleveland.
Cincinnati, Cleveland? What's the difference? It was awfully romantic.
There's nothing romantic about Cleveland, Dolly. Especially where you and me are concerned.
Well, Frank Butler, whatever are you talking about? We went strolling in the moonlight. And after trying to touch various parts of my anatomy, you proposed to me.
Proposed? I admit, I might have made a pass, but there's a hell of a big difference between a pass and a proposal.
Not to a single woman of 37, there isn't.
Darn it, Dolly, whatever happened between us is dead. Not now. It's over and done with.
A girl can still hope, can't she?
Sure, still hope she's a girl.
Darling, just the man I wanted to see. I don't much like this place, except for the student match.
That's good, because you ain't got it.
Who says?
Wilson, the proprietor. She won't rent us no rooms, neither.
Well, I'm not sleeping in a tent like that time in Schenectady.
There's nothing wrong with a tent, Dolly, long as you keep your flap shut.
Miss Wilson, I'm going to give you the chance to win $100.
You don't say.
You see, and every time, we pledge...
Mr. Butler challenges a local champion to a shoot match.
Who are you?
Mr. Butler's lovely assistant. He shoots things out of my mouth.
You don't shoot enough out of her mouth.
Miss Wilson, you bring your best man down here. I'll put up $100, I can outshoot him.
What do you take me for? There ain't nobody in all of Hamilton County who's as good as you think you are. The answer's still no. No, no, no!
I'll get one of the boys to go work on her. She looks like a widow. Maybe she's lonesome.
Nah, I'll take care of it. As soon as I finish telling her how famous I am, she'll turn right around.
Trouble with him is, he lacks confidence.
I'll thank you to give me that bird.
What bird? It's mine. I shot it.
You shot it right off my hat.
How'd it get a bar?
I sewed it up bar.
A bird? Tain't no good. Tain't got no meat on it.
It's not an eating bird, you ignorant creature. It's a wearing bird.
All right. But now you're gonna have to keep on sewing it on, because I'll just keep shooting it off.
Look at what you've done to it! You for that girl. She really is under all that gram. She's got a gun.
Is it loaded?
Sure is, but I can empty it right quick.
Ah! I wouldn't have really shot her. Buzzer
ran away.
Feller down the road a piece told me I might do some business here.
Business? What do you got?
Quails, ducks, geese, grouse, squirrels.
Nah, I got all the game I need.
Sure you do. Trouble is, with the game you got, folks keep spitting buckshot out all over your floor. Seems too crowded, but mine's different. Come on out, kids! Ladies are waiting! Shake your tails, lay on, chasers! Come on! These here are my kids' sisters and little brothers. They ain't used to people yet. They ain't never been out of Dark County before. Well, dusty, don't they? We're in business together. I pop them, the girls pluck them, and he pulls them.
Really?
And what does that boy do? Little Jake? Why, he's my bird dog. Got a great nose on him. Stepping out, he's gonna catch colds. Stop your snuffling, little Jake. Use your sleeve like everybody else. Jesse, why don't you show this lady one of them birds? Look it over, miss. Ain't no buckshot in that bird. Just one clean little hole in its head. Mighty pretty shooting. For every one I give you, you gotta give me 2 nickels and a dime. Can't hurt to try. I'll take 2 dozen.
How many's that?
20. Or, who do we know? Count up to 24.
I can count to 10.
I can count to 20.
I can only give you 20.
All right, just leave the bill with the bird.
Y'all got bills, miss.
No, the invoice, the bill. You know how to read and write, don't you?
We don't read as good as everybody.
We don't read as good as anybody.
Folks are down where I come from, they ain't had any learning. Still they're happy as can be, doing what comes naturally.
Doing what comes naturally.
Folks like us could never fuss with schools and books and learning. Still we've gone from A to Z, doing what comes naturally.
Doing what comes naturally.
You don't have to know how to read or write when you're out to the fella in the bathroom. You don't have to look in a book to find what he thinks of him or what is on his mind. That comes naturally.
That comes naturally.
My uncle out in Texas can't even write his name. He signs his checks with X's, but the cash don't fall the same. Cousin now they had her spell. She left school in honors. She got every undergree for doing what comes naturally.
For doing
what comes naturally. You don't have to go to a private school, not to pimp your penny, you're a stubborn fool.
You don't have to have the professor's dome, not to go for the honey with the bees at home.
That comes naturally.
Make that $5.
Doing what? Well, you see, there's this big, swollen head there from the wild boar.
Oh, why don't you people?
No. He's challenged anybody in the county to a shooting match.
War is it? I can hit anything he can hit, and I can do it standing on my head singing Swanee River.
But I gotta warn you, you ain't getting nothing if you lose.
Lose? That's a good one. I ain't gonna lose, miss. I can't lose.
Well, you wait right here. By the way, what's your name?
Annie. Annie Oakley.
Don't go away, Annie Oakley. Oh, Betsy, how'd you get your nose so dirty?
What's that you got there, girl?
What's it look like? Ain't you got eyes? Well, you got eyes.
Let me see that. You know you shouldn't be messing around with an old piece of junk like this, don't you? You wouldn't like it if the damn thing exploded and blew your ears off, would you? So, if you just hand this back to your pappy, get yourself a couple of knitting needles. So on.
Hey, mister. You supposed to be safe to keep it just a little longer?
Oh, I guess so. I just don't want you to hurt yourself. That's all.
I just gotta keep it long enough to win a contest off this big, swollen head stiff for the Wild West show.
You talking about Frank Butler?
No. All they said was this big, swollen head stiff.
Yeah, I heard that part. Did they also tell you he's the champion?
What's that?
Champion means he's the best.
He was?
Yeah, well, anyway. Frank Butler wouldn't shoot against no girl.
He ain't got a choice. He challenged anything. That's me, all right. Anybody. Besides, I don't shoot like a girl.
Then, what does he shoot like?
A champagne!
Pretty stuck on yourself, ain't you?
About that I am. But as soon as I put old Betsy here down to try to shut up the folks, I'm as gawky as a scrub oak. Ain't I?
Oh, I don't know. I've seen worse.
That's the nicest thing I ever heard!
Say, you wouldn't mind staying around just a little longer to bring you luck?
The way you put it, it's that big swollen-headed stiff is going to eat all the luck.
As long as you stay to see it, it's when I'm out there with all them people looking at me, I'll be looking for you.
Don't worry, honey. You'll find me. So long.
Where are you going? Don't you like me?
Sure. I like you fine. I just have to go now. That's all.
I guess I ain't exactly your type.
Look, honey, let's not.
So what is your type?
Well, I like a girl who's kind of dinky. You know, kind of face when she sees a mouse.
I suppose I'm the kind of sees a mouse in a mouse fight.
No, I didn't say that. You don't mind if you drop me something, do you?
Oh, I don't mind. So she's got me dating what it's.
You really want to hear all of this?
Well, yeah. Sure do.
Well. So